leader is a strong leader,
yeah.
but strong in the way that they influence their team and support their team,
mm-hmm.
so they inspire their team to always do their best. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing that's really important. You need committed staff. Staff who believe in the philosophy, staff who are willing to try new things and grow with the children and grow with the company is really important. Having a strong philosophy is very important. Having a philosophy that everybody not only believes, but understands. If the whole team don't understand the philosophy, then little parts are going to break down.
Yeah.
Of course you need good resources.
Yeah.
You need to have, you know, interesting toys. You need to have access to paper and pencils and crayons, all of those kind of things. You need to have excellent books for children to read and for teachers to use.
Yeah.
You need to have thought carefully about how your program works.
Yeah.
When lunchtime is, how you make the transition from, you know, the room to the bathrooms and back. All of those things add up to make a high quality program.
Mm.
And I think on top of that, you need to always be thinking, how can we be better?
Mm-hmm.
How can we make things better for parents, make things better for teachers, make things better for children? Continually thinking we need to improve. Not have the mindset of, okay, we're perfect now.
Yeah.
Because there's no such thing as perfection. Because each year you're going to have a slightly different set of children, slightly different set of parents, with different needs and different desires. So you have to constantly be reinventing and slightly changing what you do to suit the people that you have. The only thing that remains the same is change.
Yes.
it's a constant cycle, and if we're willing to grow and learn, then things can get better. There will be mistakes. There's always mistakes. But as I said before, we often learn more from our mistakes than we do from our successes.
Yeah.
And I don't know who said this quote, but I firmly believe you only fail if you stop trying.
Yeah.
Or you quit.
Yeah.
That's the only time you fail.
Yeah.
Not when you make mistakes.
Yeah. Right.
The teacher's role is to be always thinking about the child.
Mm-hmm.
Always observing the children and trying to work out better ways to get the child to think, explore, experiment, and therefore to learn. So their whole focus needs to be on not so much the children's needs, but where the children need to go. What's the potential that they can see? When's the right time to challenge this child? Or when's the right time to help this child? So they need to be always asking questions. Lots and lots of open-ended questions. Not closed questions of yes and no answers. Sometimes you will need to do that for physical needs, but you know, getting the children to think more and to try things more is really the teacher's role.
Yeah.
It isn't so much to give children knowledge, but it's to teach children how to learn and to teach children how to find out the knowledge. Obviously there is some things that teachers know because they're experienced and children don't know them. And I think we talked about dinosaurs quite a bit, and you know, children have interesting ideas about dinosaurs. And sometimes you will need to say to them, well, actually there aren't any more dinosaurs. There are some animals that are a bit like the dinosaurs, but they're not here anymore. And that can be, that's knowledge that children won't actually understand if they're very young, but they'll grow to understand that. But to challenge the thinking is the most important role of the teacher. Obviously they have a role in making sure that children stay healthy and that they get some rest and that they eat some food and drink some water, all those basic needs. But then the biggest role is to get the thinking.
Yeah.